So we're testing a range of different people across the sort of sporting spectrum of eliteness, and today we've got the England ladies cricket team coming to work with us.
It's just a really interesting day, and we're all just really looking forward to the outcome.
I'm Professor of Visual Development here at Bradford University in the School of Optometry and Vision Science. And together with some colleagues in Faculty of Engineering here at Bradford and also Liverpool John Moores University in St Andrews, we're working on a project that's examining the contribution that vision may make to eliteness in sport.
We're hoping to understand a little bit more about vision and its impact on performance, and whether or not we can identify some real raw visionary, if you like, traits or skills that our players potentially have, which we can potentially train in others and then transfer to performance and then impact more positively on performance.
We are always very competitive, and the girls that I'm with today are actually my housemates as well, so we're kind of slyly asking each other how we've done, but not giving too much away, so I'm hoping I've done well.
It's not as to whether vision is important. Vision is clearly important. The question is whether at the very top end of vision, the very sort of superior end of vision, is actually conferring an advantage, and that advantage is predisposes people to eliteness in sport. The possible implications and our motivation for doing this project wasn't just about sport. In disease, for example, in trauma, there's loss of skill, and so using elite sport as an example of how skills might be developed gives us a way perhaps of dealing with the aftermath of trauma or the consequences of disease.